देश को नष्ट होता है इतना ही, अदरवाइज कोई। डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह जी,
मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, इट हैज बीन एन ऑनर टू हैव सर्व एज ए मेंबर ऑफ दिस ऑगस्ट हाउस सिंस 1991. I have had the privilege to serve here as the leader of the opposition from 1998 to 2004 and then subsequently as the leader of the house from 2004 to 2014. Sir, the Rajya Sabha is the Council of States. I have had the privilege to represent the state of Assam as a Rajya Sabha member for 5 terms, from 1991 to 2019. Now I have the honor of representing the state of Rajasthan. India has had 2 chambers from pre-independence days. Still, it was after intense debate that the Constituent Assembly, especially the Union Constitution Committee, arrived at a consensus on the need for a bicameral system. Today, as we celebrate the 250th session of the Rajya Sabha, it is appropriate for us to reflect on whether we have lived up to the vision of the framers of our Constitution. Sir, the task before us was spelled out by our first chairman, Dr. Radhakrishnan, during the very first session of this August House. He emphasized that Parliament is not only a legislative but a deliberative body. So far as its deliberative functions are concerned, it will be open to us to make very valuable contributions. We should try to do everything in our power to justify to the public of this country that a second chamber is indeed essential to prevent hasty legislation. During the drafting of the Constitution, Shri Gopalaswamy Iyengar advanced 3 reasons why India needed a second chamber. He expected that the Rajya Sabha would A. hold dignified debates, B. delay legislation which might be the outcome of passions of the moment, and C. provide opportunities to seasoned people who might not be in the thick set of political fray but who might be willing to participate in the debates with the amount of learning and importance we do not ordinarily associate with the House of the People, unquote. For the manner in which the role of the Rajya Sabha has evolved, we have much to thank Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. He asserted that neither House had any particular superiority over the other. He regarded the Rajya Sabha as an equal partner with Lok Sabha in the affairs of the state. But for his effort, the Rajya Sabha would have been reduced to a mere second or revising chamber and relegated to a secondary position in our parliamentary system. Pandit Nehru asserted, and I quote, "The successful working of our constitution, as of any democratic structure, demands the closest cooperation between the two houses. They are, in fact, parts of the same structure, and any lack of that spirit of cooperation and accommodation would lead to difficulties and come in the way of proper functioning of our constitution. It is therefore particularly to be regretted that any sense of conflict should arise between the two houses," unquote. Sir, as explained by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar in the Constituent Assembly, the Rajya Sabha represents a crucial component of the constitutional system of checks and balances. We normally think of checks and balances as operating the different branches of government. However, the Rajya Sabha has a central role to provide checks and balances to a majority government in the Lok Sabha, along with its other key role is to represent the interests of the states in our federal union. When there is criticism of Rajya Sabha, it is fundamentally a misunderstanding of these historic roles bestowed upon this august chamber. It is our duty to ensure that no laws is passed in haste and in an atmosphere of heightened emotion. That said, are there ways in which we can improve our functioning so that we come closer to the idealistic vision of our nation's founder? When it comes to deliberation, sir, we start with an advantage. The Rajya Sabha gets more time to deliberate in comparison to the Lok Sabha, since we are only half the size, and therefore members get more time to share their insights and criticism. But we can help our member perform even better through some procedural improvement. The House must get access to bill much earlier than is the case now. Members should get additional resources such as adequate research staff to allow them to study issues in more depth, and nominated members and those with special expertise in particular topics should be allotted more time for their speech.